It's time for the Taco Truck Roundup, the show where I help you figure out what to buy on AppSumo. This week's focus is on AppSumo Originals. If you didn't know, AppSumo actually codes their own applications and then sells them as lifetime deals right on AppSumo.com. Turns out they're some of the best bang for your buck that you'll find on the entire marketplace. So in this video, I'm going to give you a broad overview of each of the four AppSumo originals that have been released to date. If you're interested in any one of the tools, I'll have a full-length video available that goes deep into each tool and shows you all of the nooks and crannies and exactly what I think of each application. For now, let's get right into the very first tool, which chronologically released was KingSumo. So this is my KingSumo contest that I'm running right now. You can see I've got a product that I'm giving away up top here. I've got a nice little headline, a countdown timer, and then a way to actually enter by submitting my name and email address. Let's go ahead and do this. I've entered my email address in. I'm gonna press the green button, and then I get a little animation of confetti here and some options to gain additional entries into the contest that I set up when I created the contest. So my options here are to share on social media like Twitter, Facebook, or Facebook Messenger, share via email, or take some actions over on YouTube like subscribe to my channel or watch a specific video. I can add my own logo, but there is some light KingSumo branding that you can't get rid of. One of the best things about KingSumo is that you can use it completely free. You can see there's a free plan right here. If I click on the deal for AppSumo, which I will link to in the description, by the way, let's go down to the bottom here. You can see you get unlimited use of this tool for absolutely nothing. Now, if you upgrade to their lifetime plan, which is $49, you're gonna get a lot more features, things like conversion tracking and having additional entry fields if you wanna collect some specific data about people who enter your contests. There's no way to white label your contests in terms of removing the KingSumo branding completely and then host the contest on your own domain. However, you can embed the page that we just saw on our own domain. So in essence, it will appear to be on your website. Creating a giveaway is super easy. So you just fill out this form here with all of the information about the prize you want to give away, set up the bonus entries, things like those additional signups. You have integrations with Zapier, SendFox, Klaviyo, MailChimp, and a few other applications. There's also an API, so you can create your own integration if you want to. Set up your terms and rules, which you can customize by checking right here, and then you're off to the races. Like I mentioned a moment ago, you can embed your contest on any website you like. Just grab the embed code right here, put it on a page on your website, and you're good to go. However, if you prefer, just copy the link and then share it directly with your audience. Contests can be a great way to get referrals and new signups to your email list. So I do advise you add those additional signup options, which encourage people to share the contest with others. That's one way you'll get exposure to your contest and it'll be more effective. Overall, KingSumo is a very straightforward and easy to use giveaway platform. If you're looking for straight up giveaways with very little bells and whistles and not a lot of extra frills, definitely check out KingSumo. I mentioned the pricing was just $49 lifetime, which is considerably cheaper than most similar giveaway platforms. However, I should point out that if you're an AppSumo Plus member, you get KingSumo Pro absolutely free. So in my opinion, that is the best way to get KingSumo. Just sign up for a year of AppSumo Plus and you'll get access to it. Dollar for dollar and feature for feature, I don't think you can beat KingSumo for this style of giveaway. I give this one an 8.7 out of 10. I highly recommend checking it out. I'll have a link down in the description if you'd like to do so. And this is the perfect time to say thank you to AppSumo for supporting this roundup. The next AppSumo original that was released chronologically is called SendFox. SendFox is a competitor to MailChimp. You can probably draw that conclusion just based on the similarities in names. Now, truth be told, when SendFox was originally released, I did a full-length review of it here on this channel, and I wasn't a super big fan. It had a few big things that were kind of drawbacks for me, namely deliverability issues, problems with branding kind of being littered all over the emails, and there was also the confusion of integrations. How were you going to connect your email sending application up to your website? As a new application, they hadn't figured out all that stuff yet. So I'm happy to say that 4 years later and much of this has been solved. So let's go through and I'll kind of show you how SendFox works and then point out those gripes and the solutions to them. Now, first, let's talk about the branding issues, because if you look at the plans here, you're going to see that tier one and tier two still have SendFox branding. Tier three and tier four and five have light SendFox branding, but there's no way in the lifetime deals to remove that completely. However, I should point out that this is an incredible value because for tier five, $245 one-time purchase, you're getting 25,000 subscribers. If you use another platform like MailChimp, ConvertKit, or Klaviyo, you're going to be looking at anywhere from $150 to $400 per month. So thousands of dollars per year. However, with SendFox, you get that taken care of with a one-time flat fee. Super amazing. They've solved the branding issue by offering a paid monthly add-on. So that kind of removes the LTD-ness of it. But when you compare it to those other plans, it's absolutely a bargain. We're looking at $10 a month and you'll be able to white label your, so basically add your own logo and turn off SendFox branding. $120 a year. It is billed monthly, so you can try it out for a little bit and see if it's a good fit. If you don't like having the branding removed, you can simply turn this off. They call this the Empire add-on, and you're gonna get a few other things over just the standard lifetime plan. One of those things is improved deliverability. So you can see here that deliverability for the free account is considered normal, lifetime plan is better, and with the Empire add-on, it's best. So you're probably escalated up to a little bit more of a regulated IP pool, so your deliverability should be better here. All of the emails are sent out through SendGrid, if you're curious. Integration-wise, I'm seeing a lot more applications support SendFox. One that's important to me is WP Fusion. They now support SendFox. And overall, just the experience of using SendFox is vastly improved from where it was 4 years ago. Here's the email creation page, and you can create a new email by clicking right here. It's got a very basic text editor, which in my opinion is perfect for content creators and small businesses that want to have a more personal connection with their audience. However, if you want to use an HTML template that you've downloaded off of another website, you can certainly do so. You can switch over to code mode right here. Or if you get that Empire add-on, you can open it up into the code editor, which will give you full access to all of the code for the email. The automations aren't extremely complex, but I think that's not really what they're going for here. They want that MailChimp competitor, something that's just very simple to use, do everything that people want on a regular basis without making things overly complex. One feature I love is called Smart Campaigns, where you can connect up some sources, so like your YouTube channel, your podcast, or your blog, and then that content will automatically come into SendFox so that you can publish emails based on that content. So this is the Smart Campaigns settings page. I can click right here to manage the sources, and here I can enter in my blog URL, my podcast URL, or my YouTube URL. Then in my Smart Campaigns, I could simply have it create a weekly newsletter based on everything that was published to those different platforms. Like, for example, here I have the website as well as my YouTube channel selected. Emails can be published automatically, or you can set them to be scheduled manually. Now you can use those sources like your YouTube channel or your podcast and then create emails manually if you like as well. Just hit create new email and then right down here you can choose the email generator. It's going to find all of your latest videos, like here's one I published late last week. I can choose this. It's going to be checked right here. I can add as many as I want, by the way. Let's say I wanted to have a roundup email that goes out. I can choose a few videos that I'd like to focus on. Hit generate email. It's going to say this is going to replace everything in your existing email. Okay. And then there you go. You've got an email generated based on your content. Here it's pulling in the description from YouTube and the thumbnail from YouTube. There's a bunch more cool features that we don't have time to go into in this video. Things like smart pages. You don't have to have a website to get people to sign up for your email list. Or if you do have a website, you can create your own form so that people can sign up and you can embed that form right on your page. So I'm going to give SendFox a 7.9 out of 10. I think this is an absolute easy recommendation for anyone who's just getting started with email marketing, who doesn't need a lot of different features when it comes to sending out emails. You want to do newsletters and then basic follow-up drip sequences. SendFox is a no-brainer recommendation, especially at $49. Or hey, you also get this one for free when you sign up for AppSumo Plus. What would make SendFox better? Well, I think some deeper integrations with things like WooCommerce or Shopify would get people in droves coming over to SendFox and abandoning those expensive Klaviyo accounts, things like that. Next up is TidyCal. This is AppSumo's reaction to Calendly. Basically, it's a scheduling tool that does feature for feature nearly everything that Calendly does. Here is a booking page for a 30-minute meeting with me. I can choose a time and date right here. So 9 o'clock on May 21st, I can enter my name, my email address, book the event. And there we go, booking confirmed. I can add this event to my calendar, download an ICS file if I prefer that method, book another meeting if I need to have a series of meetings, although they do have reoccurring meetings available as well. It's just a different appointment type. And I can even cancel or reschedule the meeting right here. So if I choose reschedule, it's gonna pop me back into this page where I can choose a different time. I could hit cancel over here if I wanted to cancel the meeting altogether. There we go, booking is now canceled. Here's what TidyCal looks like on the back end. You can add your new booking types right here. It's essentially a form that you fill out with a title. You can add your own custom URL, a description, even add a photo if you like, choose the days and times you would be available. And if you prefer, you can set up a specific date. This is a really cool feature. If you're doing, let's say, an event on a singular day and you wanna book appointments for, I don't know, a conference or something like that, you can have people book with you on that specific day and have a dedicated URL for that specific event. There are advanced features here as well. I think it has everything you will find inside of Calendly, such as adding the buffer time before and after meetings, setting up online video conferencing integrations with things like Zoom or Microsoft Teams or Google Meet. You can do group bookings and you can allow people to invite guests. Now, once again, I go into great detail over TidyCal in my full-length video, so I'll link to that down below if you want to learn more about TidyCal and how it works. However, I want to point out that TidyCal is by far, in my opinion, the best value when it comes to AppSumo Originals. TidyCal is just $29 for a single user, and there's no plans to choose from. So if you want to get TidyCal for everyone in your business, just buy it 4, 5, 10, 100 times, whatever you need, and it's $29 a pop. Now, the downsides of this are just like KingSumo, there's no way to completely remove the TidyCal branding. It will always be present when people are booking with you. However, for me, booking an appointment, not nearly as important to keep it completely on brand as something like sending an email, like I already mentioned. I feel like that's a much more personal connection. When you compare this to the pricing of Calendly at $10 per month or $120 a year, because this is annual pricing, if we go over to monthly pricing, it's even more, $120 per year versus $29 once, it's absolutely a slam dunk clear decision. Like I already mentioned, I don't have time to go into every single detail of TidyCal, but let me hit on a few more important points. You can accept money for appointments. If you want to connect up your PayPal or your Stripe account, you can accept payments. You can also embed your appointments on your own website, just like you did with KingSumo. So if you're worried about that lack of control of the branding, well, you will still have the TidyCal logo, but you can add that to your own website. Each booking type has its own embed code, so you can add it to your website, or if you want to offer a booking page, you can embed this on your website as well. So as I've already mentioned, I feel as though TidyCal is the most valuable of all of the AppSumo originals. I give it an 8.7 out of 10. I think everybody needs a booking tool at some point, and for $29 one time, you can't really beat this. Absolute slam dunk. Great job on this one, AppSumo team. And the latest AppSumo original, as of the recording of this video, is called BreezeDoc. BreezeDoc allows you to send off a PDF to someone, add in some custom fields, allow them to sign in a legally binding way, and off to the races, you profit, you get your liabilities covered, whatever you like to do with your documents. Let me show you how this works quickly, and then we'll talk about pros and cons. BreezeDoc's layout is dead simple, and again, I have a full-length review of this if you want to go deeper, but essentially, there's a template section right here. We can add templates if we want to have a reusable document that, let's say, our business uses a release form constantly. We could add that as a template. However, AppSumo does give you some templates to work from. There's this one right here called the Business Coaching Agreement Template. I'm going to create a document based on this, and you can see there's all of these fields here that have kind of this reddish-orange color. These are for the coach to fill out. So this is an agreement between a coach and a client. The coach would be able to customize the agreement, and then the client would receive this via email and then be able to sign it. The client's signatures are right here in this kind of slightly brighter orangish yellow color. Now this is a template, so the document is already completely done for you, but you would just as easily upload your own PDF and add your own fields where you want to mark things up. Your choices of fields are signature, text, checkbox, date, and initials. So for example, let's pretend that this is actually a signature field right here. What I would do is choose the party that I want to sign. Let's say I want the client to sign. I will click on their name, grab the field that I like over here, and just drag and drop it where I'd like it to go. Then I can resize it as I see fit. And there we go. I've got my signature field added to my document. When I'm all done, I can send this off to the recipients. And there's even a handy activity feed to show you everything that's happening in terms of people viewing and signing your document. BreezeDoc is also super affordable. That's kind of the theme running throughout this roundup. $0 to get started. That's their free plan. It's kind of just meant for more of a trial because I think for $9, again, this is really $24, $9, you're going to get all of the features added in. Things like unlimited templates, basically access to the template system, and multiple recipients. Without those two things, I feel like BreezeDoc is a lot less usable. However, if you just need a single document to be signed by somebody, hey, sign up for tier one. You can do 2 a month. Now there's 4 total tiers of BreezeDoc. By the time you get to tier 4, you're spending a whopping $39 one time for document signing for life. Absolutely amazing. Remember that these are AppSumo LTDs, so chances are they're basically going to be available to you on AppSumo for as long as AppSumo exists. I don't think they'll be sunsetting any of these. I don't see why they would. So you can feel most confident in buying one of these LTDs because AppSumo has the built-in audience coming and buying this software continuously. It's going to exist for a long period of time. I feel like if you need to upgrade from tier 2 to tier 3, there's probably not a huge rush to do so. You can see here it says you can upgrade between the 4 license tiers while the deal is available. And I have not heard anything about any of these AppSumo Originals going to a strictly monthly plan. I mean, anything is possible. I don't work for AppSumo. I don't know what their plans are, but I get the feeling that these are kind of lifetime deals, if you know what I'm saying. Downsides of BreezeDoc, I would say that their template library is still brand new. I have heard rumblings they are going to be expanding on that. So I'm hopeful to see that they add a lot more templates because that is a very useful part of a signing platform. The other downside I would say is there's not really any integrations with third-party tools right now. So it'd be really nice to even connect up something like, oh, I don't know, maybe your calendar tool to send off an agreement when someone books a paid appointment with you. Kind of seems obvious. TidyCal plus BreezeDoc, no brainer. Now I do have a full-length BreezeDoc video already available, and one person pointed out that 40 documents per month is not enough for them. So if that's the case for you, then I'm just afraid BreezeDoc is probably not gonna be a good fit because AppSumo has not hinted at all that they'll be adding higher level tiers in terms of the amount of documents. So if you're having hundreds of customers per month and each one needs to sign a waiver or something like that, well, this isn't gonna be a good option for those types of businesses. So that's it. That's all of the AppSumo Originals. Thank you for watching this Taco Truck Roundup. If you liked the video, make sure you hit the like button to let me know you enjoyed it. Or hey, just leave me a comment down below, ask a question, or tell me you liked the video. I love hearing from everybody out there. My name is Dave Swift. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.